here as living waters for the world. It's a mission project through the Presbytery that brings clean water to third world countries, and you're going to hear all about it today. And we'll be taking mission donations for them for the next couple of weeks. We'll have a table set up in the parish hall afterwards, or you can fill out an envelope through your office at that time. I'd like to pull your announcements and the grateful as she said. And we'd like to add Michael Miller to the prayer list. And just read through it for the upcoming chapter. Let the worship begin.
the violin call, sing silent, with hand drama, to this water will never run dry. Come, all for safety, to Jesus our Lord.
We are so thirsty for the living water that only you can give us. We confess that we are baffled by the things of the earth, and we seek to satisfy our deepest needs with the power of the solutions. And you are the greatest of all for us. We fill our lives with busyness, and we wonder why we are unfulfilled. We are our priority according to the demand of our society, and we wonder why our lives are out of control. We want
one would you choose?
Yeah.
Marion Griffin.
The moment when a crowded teen center puppy knows that dirty water is here and turns it back because of
welcome, Chip.
Do you know any boys or girls who have to drink water that looks like this?
Anybody?
No. No, we're very lucky here, where we live. Our water comes straight out of the tap of clean, healthy water. But the fact is that there are millions of boys and girls in the world that have to drink water like this. Because they have no clean water to drink in their homes and they can't afford to buy clean water. These children are sick a lot, and thousands of them can even die from the diseases that they catch from the dirty water. So that makes it sad. Me too. And I believe that if God said all the time, these children suffer.
Can you think of a way that we might be able to help those boys and girls to have clean water?
Did anybody think of a way that they can have clean water? They might not have bottles of water in those countries if they're in a country far away. They might not have that. Let's listen and see if we can find out.
The good news is that there is a way we can help. If we can help their communities to build a system that can clean their water, they may be able to have water like this. And our church is taking the children a collection today to help pay for water system for communities where the children need clean water. The money will go to Living Water for the World. And the people there will use it to fund those boys and girls and help them to have clean water. Do you think that's a good thing for Christians to do?
Yes.
We know that God cares about our bodies and wants us to be healthy and strong.
Now it's time. Pray. God, we know that you love all the children of the world. When you try to help the children, you have to drink dirty water. Please help us remember every time we drink our clean water that we should care about them and help them do what Jesus loves us and Jesus loves them too. In his name we pray, amen.
Amen. Hey, go back to your seat.
Thank you.
Let us offer prayers of those who are listed in our bulletin and close to our hearts. Those with broken hearts and broken lives, bless them with healing. Change their circumstances. Cause peace and prosperity to come to them in abundance. Lift us up with your blessings today. Pray that you will anoint us with strength and self-care. Encourage us throughout the day and the week to take the correct steps to walk proudly in your steps. Let us join together as we were taught. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever.
Living Waters of the World. Today we celebrate the work and amazing work of Living Waters to the World, the global mission project for the Sinai of Living Water of the Presbyterian Church. Living Waters for the World partners with communities in need to develop a sustainable solution for providing clean water from rural Appalachia to Latin America to Africa and beyond. Living Waters for the World is making a difference. Consider these facts. Over 660 million people lack access to safe drinking water. The effect of this alarming fact is that 3 million people each year die of water-related illness, and most are children. Needless to say, water-related illness is the leading cause of death among children throughout the world. For over 20 years, Living Waters of the World has been meeting this crisis head-on with a water treatment system and a learning process that is ideal for youth in churches, health clinics, schools, and orphanages throughout the world. By providing a system that's simple, sustainable, and affordable, and by teaching local leaders to lead health, hygiene, and spiritual education in the community, Living Waters for the World and its partners have been able to help those in communities with contaminated water take ownership of making their own water safe to use and drink. In 2004, Living Waters for the World began a training program called Clean Water Youth, where mission team leaders come to learn how to install the water treatment system and how to train local leaders in the field. Since then, over 2,000 volunteers have been trained from throughout the United States and several other countries. And the effect of that training is that we celebrate today. From 1996 to the beginning of 2004, Living Waters for the World and its dedicated band of volunteers installed 20 water systems in 5 countries. Today, there are almost 800 Living Waters for the World systems serving communities in 25 countries throughout the world. And the most amazing part, this appears to be just the beginning of what the Holy Spirit has planned. Today is a day to celebrate, to give thanks, and to directly respond to what the Holy Spirit is calling us to do, and to be as partners of Living Waters for the World. Let us give it. Thank you.
One such ministry is Living Waters for the World.
a ministry of the Presbyterian Church, which has partnered with communities in developing countries in many parts of the world, establishing more than 500 water treatment systems to transform contaminated water into clean, healthy, drinkable water. These water ministries are not just about pipes and filters and water tests or education. They are about real people. So we thought perhaps you'd like to actually hear some of the stories of some real people who have been affected by clean water made available to them through these water ministries. Maybe knowing more about their lives, you'll feel encouraged to support such ministries with your time, talent, and treasure. That is our hope. And to that end, we're going to bring you some stories about some real people whose real physical needs are being met.
I am Benjamin. I'm 9 years old and I live in Madagascar. I used to be sick a lot. It was terrible. My friends mostly had the same problems, so we missed a lot of school. It's hard to try to learn when you feel bad, so most of us didn't do very well in school. But now it's all different. Now we have clean water for drinking and cooking, and we're not sick nearly so much. And when we go to school, we feel good enough to pay attention and learn. My teacher says it's a miracle.
Yes, a miracle indeed. Imagine the wasted potential in the children of the world whose education has been dramatically impacted by illness. Imagine the toll that chronic illness takes on the developing bodies and brains of these children. Children that will never be able to reach their God-given potential because of preventable war and more disease. Thankfully, Benjamin Nady may now grow to his full potential.
I'm Maria. I had 5 children, but 3 of them died in childhood of intestinal diseases. Now I have 7 grandchildren, 2 of whom were very sick with intestinal symptoms just last year. But then our community received a water treatment system, and clean water became available to us at an affordable price for the first time. I'm so grateful that my grandchildren will have a better chance of survival than my children did, thanks to clean water that they now have to drink.
Illness and death of children are a constant reality in much of the world, due primarily to waterborne disease, which is the number one cause of death in the world for children under 5 years of age. If you have children or grandchildren, or if there is a child that you will fear, then you will know how Maria feels to think that her little ones now have a chance to grow to maturity without the constant threat of deadly illness.
My name is Lewis. I'm a typical teenager into things like soccer and girls and horsing around. I'm good in school and I'm planning on completing high school in a few years. You know, a year ago that wouldn't have been possible. I would have to quit school because my family needed me to work and to help provide for my younger brothers and sisters. The average wage in our community is about $45 per week, and we used to spend more than $10 of that to buy clean water in bottles, because we know that the water from our wells is contaminated and can make us sick or even kill us. But recently, a new clean water system has been put into operation in our town, which will make the cost of water much more affordable. Now we'll have more money for other things, and I'll be able to finish school too.
In some parts of the world, bottled water is available, but very expensive. In other places, some people cannot afford it at all, and others forego other important things like education in order to stay healthy by buying water. In communities like this, the economic improvement can be as dramatic as the improvement in health when clean water is made affordable. The ripple effect of available clean water is significant.
My name is Angela, and I am 12 years old. I live in Orange and Ghana. Living in close quarters with 79 other children, I often catch whatever illness the other children have. It's hard to avoid when we're so close together. We suspect that most of the sickness comes from our water, but we have to drink it anyway. What choice do we have?
Unlike Benjamin and Maria and Lewis, Angela's community has no clean water source. Angela is one of the millions of children in the world who are waiting for the privilege of clean water. Today, we have an opportunity to pray for a day when clean water is available for all of God's children, not just the privileged. Unfortunately, many children like Angela will die before that day. In fact, every 12 seconds somewhere in the world, someone dies from a preventable water-related disease. That means that in the time we have been assembled in the room, nearly 300 people have died, and most of them are children.
Then the righteous answer him, "Lord, when was it we saw you hungry and gave you food? And when was it we saw you thirsty and gave you water?" And the king will answer them, "Truly, I tell you, just as you did it for one of the least of these who are members of my family, you did it for me."
The past decades provided us with numerous examples of natural disasters. Floods, tsunamis, earthquakes,
that have taken thousands of lives. That's a staggering number of deaths, and the world has responded to these disasters with admirable relief efforts. This worldwide response is wonderful, and it has happened because these disasters were sudden, visible, and highly publicized. Yet consider this. In that same decade, more than 30 million people have died from preventable water-related diseases in developing countries around the globe. But the world takes little note of their deaths, for they have died slowly, silently, and without the media coverage. In the story of the Samaritan woman at the well, Jesus offers living water. But look more closely at the story. Verse 7. Jesus says to the woman, "Give me a drink." Jesus offers her the water of eternal life, but he also asks her to give him a drink of very real water to satisfy his very real physical need. Read this story through the lens of Matthew 25. "Lord, when did we see you thirsty and give you something to drink?" Jesus is living today, living among the least of these in Haiti, Belize, Honduras, Mexico, Guatemala, India, Brazil, Nicaragua, Ghana. And through their voices, Jesus says to us, "Give me a drink." And it's to remind us of his request, lest we should forget with his dying words, Jesus said, "I thirst." But we believe that the Spirit of God is working to alleviate the world's water crisis, working through ministries of clean water in many places, working in a tangible way, using flesh and blood of people like you and me, working towards a world where all of God's children will have life and have it abundantly. This is good news, and we are the people called to share that good news to the end of the earth. Thanks be to God. Amen. Please join me in the affirmation of faith contained in the book. We believe in God,
Creator of all things, sustainer of all life. We believe in the righteous lives, humanity in turn, redeemer of all earthly beings of our universe. We believe in the Spirit deep within us, advocate God, who lives with us eternally. We believe in God's resurrection, the created world, where all things are fixed, and all creation fits together in our harmonies. We believe in God above, beside,
Amen. Beautiful.